Hello and welcome to the channel. Be sure to share, like, and comment down below. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button for daily videos on news and politics. Donald Trump Jr. on leaker Adam Schiff. He says, I think he's got some soul searching to do. Donald Trump Jr. went on with Jesse Waters on Saturday night. Now, this comes after the Senate Judiciary Committee released more than 1,800 pages of transcripts on Donald Jr.'s meeting with a Russian attorney at the Trump Tower in June of 2016. Now, the documents offer more proof that Don Jr.'s account of the meeting that the Russian lawyer Natalia Veselinskaya used the opportunity to lobby against the Magnitsky Act, prompting Trump, who had been promised dirt on Hillary Clinton, to end the meeting after 20 minutes, was in fact exactly what happened. Now, this also comes after the New York Times reported that the FBI opened an investigation dubbed Crossfire Hurricane into Trump's campaign 100 days before the presidential election. The FBI was spying on the opposition party's campaign 100 days before the election. The spying was based on a phony Russian dossier that was paid for by the Democrats and Hillary Clinton, and by the hearsay of a low-level Trump campaign official who was coached by FBI operatives as Russian rumors. And the FBI informant used thousands of dollars to entice Trump campaign official Papadopoulos to London to set up meetings. Now, Don Jr. had this to say on leaker Adam Schiff. He says, I think he's got some soul searching to do. Look, 99% of intelligent people believe he's the person leaking this.
Judiciary Committee releasing transcripts of interviews conducted about the Trump Tower meeting with a Russian lawyer. The takeaways? Don didn't even know any Russians would be attending the meeting. And the Russians never even had any dirt on Hillary. No info changed hands, no money was paid, unlike the crooked Hillary fake dossier. Here's what Trump Jr. had to say about the Russia investigation and the media circus surrounding his meeting earlier this year.
What I want people to do is really think, what if Bush had done this to Obama?
Mm-hmm.
What would the reaction be? I've never seen the media more interested in not having more information.
I know.
In my life.
They're supposed to want information.
No, we don't want it. Because they're all complicit in this.
Yeah.
What's been great about, you know, the last year of nonsense that I've had to go through is that the only collusion that's been uncovered is that of the high-level FBI, because we do have to make the distinction between the guys at the top, the lawyers that run the FBI on the seventh floor, and the guys that do the real door kicking and the real work on the bottom.
What do you call them? The boots and the suits?
Boots and suits. It's a big difference.
So let's just talk about the conspiracy for a second here, because it's many layers.
Yeah.
What they're alleging in the memo is that this guy paid for by Hillary, he's a foreign agent, he created all this fake dirt about your father, and then shopped it to the Washington Post, CNN, New York Times, and then took those reports, the FBI and the DOJ did, and then gave it to the judge to help bolster
the credibility
of the warrant application. Exactly. And so the Washington Post and the New York Times, the whole year and a half, they must have known this thing was bogus and that they were in cahoots with him.
Because they were working with the source.
They worked with him.
And no one else could get away with this other than the Obama administration. And this is why it's clear. They weaponized the FBI and the DOJ to attack the duly elected president of the United States.
What does this say now about the entire investigation? Is it rotten to the core?
Listen, it always has been.
You're right.
We always said this. I mean, it is so ridiculous that let it go, though. At this point, let it go.
There's nothing to hide.
Nothing. The real problem that I've had with it is, other than, you know, millions in legal fees and lots of time wasted and being smeared throughout the media for years, that at least they uncovered this, because what if they wouldn't have? What if they would have just let it go? At this point, I mean, there is a little bit of sweet revenge in it for me and certainly probably the family, in the sense that if they wouldn't have done this, this stuff would be going on.
You're right.
This would be going on at the highest levels of government. They'd be continuing to do it to my father, trying to undermine his actions. Imagine how effective he can be given the year he's had without this cloud over his head. So I want them to come, but come to a conclusion already, because you've been looking for 2 years. You've come up with nothing other than their own nefarious actions and their own collusions. They've come up with nothing. So at this point, you got to come to something. Like, just come to something. Because if they try to drag it out for a year, they try to drag it so that, you know, the Democrats have their talking points. I watch it right now. You see the Democratic senators, this is McCarthyism. I'm like, what? You have a guy that's been screaming, Russia, 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 with no evidence, obvious collusion, all this shade, for 18 months screaming about McCarthyism? I mean, the irony is ridiculous at this point.
One of the people that's been giving you a hard time is Schiff, one of the, I think, House Intelligence Committee minority leaders, Democrat. What would you like to say to Adam Schiff right now?
Well, listen, I think he's got some soul searching to do. He's been out there, you know, obviously 99% of intelligent people believe he's the person leaking this. When I did my testimony to his committee, it was supposed to be behind closed doors. It was supposed to be secret. We get done at 7 o'clock at night. I go, and starting at 12 o'clock in my Twitter feed, I'm reading about verbatim what's going on in the room. So as people are taking bathroom breaks, this is being leaked from the House Intelligence Committee. Think about that. But that's what's going on in our government. These guys, and I can see the response that he's had with, he's scared. Because he's had the media in their back pockets, as we see from all of this.
Yep.
These guys are working together with the radical left, and they're getting whatever they want done. The problem is, they used to have some credibility, so people still believe that, so they're able to sell that narrative. That's why you could see them ramping up so effectively to try to say, oh, this isn't really a big deal. Oh, this is made up. Oh, this is going to be a big dud.
So you've had two competing narratives that have gone on for the last year. You have on the one side in the media on the left that Donald Trump is a colluder, he's an obstructor of justice, and he was in cahoots with the Russians in order to help win the presidency. On the other hand, you've had people reporting a lot of this on our network. It turns out to be true now that the Department of Justice and the FBI under President Obama rigged the investigation for Hillary and then really turned the screws to Trump. And now it looks like in a corrupt and illegal way. Huh? And the facts are out now. And the facts belong on this side.
100%. And by the way, this has been a much more recent narrative, frankly, than the other. I mean, they've been looking at the other one for over 2 years.
You're right.
Okay, when they found, I took a meeting, 20-minute meeting. Big, but they needed it to
be
true. You're
so much like your dad. I took a meeting.
But they need, they needed it to be true because they staked their entire credibility. Their whole narrative, that was, oh, now we can keep going. Now we can keep on the heat because they all knew what
was going on. So what does this do to the media's credibility, which wasn't high to begin with? Now after this whole hoax exposed, what does it do?
Listen, I just think it gets rid of the notion that there's any objectivity left. And I can say that for both sides. But there's no objectivity
except Waters'
left.
World. You
obviously. Well, that's, you know, you're the exception.
Fair and balanced.
There is none anymore, and as long as people understand that when they're watching, that you can, it's really news entertainment. That's why you're saying, to fill a 24-hour news cycle, you have to do this. People are giving their opinions. They're no longer relaying news. They're relaying news with their preferred choice of spin. And that's a shame, because you're doing a disservice to other people who actually really want to get real news.
Up next, Diamond and Silk.
So be sure to share, like, subscribe, and comment down below and tell me how you feel about this report. But other than that, I hope you guys have a great day. Let's make America great again. I appreciate you. Peace.